Factor trinomials without a leading coefficient. If the leading coefficient in front is a 1, then the two numbers will add to the middle. So basically, right now, we're dealing with the same kinds of problems as before, but this is going to be a shortcut that we can use. But we definitely need to remember, note, that this will only work if the leading coefficient is 1. But it'll be a nice shortcut in those cases. So let's go ahead and take a closer look at how we can use this shortcut. So in example 1, we've got x squared minus 2x minus 8. Again, when we're factoring trinomials, start out with our parentheses. And we're going to try and find something that multiplies to give us this x squared. That part's going to be really easy because it's just x times x gives us x squared. And then we also want something that's going to multiply together to give us this negative 8. So we could certainly use our guess and check method here. And we could go ahead and say this is maybe plus 1 and this is minus 8. But the trick that we're learning in this video is going to tell us a little bit more, since we have this 1 in front, about what we want these two numbers to do. So in this case, we want these two numbers to add to the middle. So we've got a negative 2x right here, and it looks like this 1 and the negative 7 are not going to add to give me this negative 2. So even without going through and doing my FOIL, I'm getting an idea that that might not be what I want. So let's go ahead instead and try plus 2 minus 4. So these two will still multiply together to give me the negative 8, plus when I add this positive 2 and this negative 4, I'll get the negative 2 in the middle. So our shortcut for today is telling us this should now work. So we'll just double check and make sure that this is giving us exactly what we want. We'll FOIL back together, and we'll multiply the first terms to give us x squared, and then the outside terms minus 4x, and our inside terms is plus 2x. And then our last terms is minus 8. Combine like terms and we'll get x squared minus 2x minus 8, which is exactly the expression that we started with. So this trick is working for us. So now we know that this right here is our final answer. The product of these two expressions successfully gives us our original expression. So, let's go ahead and take a look at example 2. So in example 2, we've got x squared plus 7xy minus 8y squared. So we've got a 1 as the coefficient of our x squared again. So now we can go ahead and use our fancy-dancy shortcut. So, let's see. We know that we're going to have x times x to give us the x squared. And now we're looking for two different things to multiply together to give us this negative 8y squared. So that could be something like, negative 2 and positive 4. But I can already tell that negative 2 and positive 4 are not going to give me this positive 7 in the middle. So, let's see, maybe we could try something like positive 1 and a negative 8. Both these should have a y next to them, so we can get our y squared. Looks like that's still not going to work, because then I would have positive, negative, and the bigger one's negative, so then we would get a negative 7. That's not too bad. I'll just go ahead and change the signs. So now we've got minus 1 plus 8. Okay, so now these two will add up to our positive 7 in the middle. And again, we'll just go ahead and FOIL this out and make sure that we're getting exactly what we want. First terms together is x squared. Last outside terms together is going to give us plus 8xy. Inside terms together is going to give us minus 1xy. And the last terms together is going to give us minus 8y squared. Combine our like terms and we get x squared plus 7xy minus 8y squared. And that's exactly the expression that we started with. So now we know that the product of these two expressions will give us our original expression. So this is successfully factored.